All right. There's do's and don'ts, right? Do's and don'ts to everything. All right. You're thinking about moving to New Braunfels, Texas. That's why you're watching this. Today in this video, we're going to talk about 5 don'ts and 5 do's when it comes to moving to New Braunfels, Texas. Make sure you stick around because they're all important. Okay. All right. Let's get started. All right. So you're thinking about moving to New Braunfels, Texas. That's why you're watching my channel. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. I hope that these are useful. I've had this channel for almost 3 years now, and I just love making this content and, you know, just giving y'all as much value as I can so you can make a good decision, a good informed decision. And today we're gonna talk about do's and don'ts of moving to New Braunfels, Texas, and what you need to know. Real quick, before we start, make sure you go smash that like button. And if you're not following me already, if you haven't subscribed, hit subscribe. And let me know where you're following from. I'm always curious where people are following from and where you're watching from. And so yeah, just drop that in the comments below. So, okay, 5 don'ts, right? The first don't is don't not call me, okay? Yeah, I'm just not a YouTube talking head. I'm a realtor here in New Braunfels, Texas, and I've helped dozens of people move here that have just called me from this YouTube channel. And I don't know, I just love it. So me and my partners, we just love helping people move here. I wasn't born and raised in New Braunfels, but I have been in this area for, oh my gosh, going on 24 years. Okay, I'm 46, so you can do the math. But yeah, I can't imagine really living anywhere else. Love New Braunfels. My family and I love it. We're, you know, my wife Megan and I were raising our kids here, but I was also a police officer in New Braunfels. Okay, so there's only a small handful of realtors in New Braunfels that have that law enforcement background, and it's going to be police officers that have that intimate knowledge of like the entire city and the area. Okay, we get paid to drive around and for like 10 to 12 hours a day, so we're going to be well aware of like different traffic patterns throughout the day, throughout the year. You know, maybe it gets busier in this one area of town, you know, in certain months or certain weekends, you know, certain time frames. So that really helps me a lot in my business, is just intimately knowing the city, okay? So yeah, one of the first don't is don't not call me, all right? I've heard people say, oh, I don't want to bother them or anything. No, 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 call me. I answer the phone, I respond to the emails. It's me, I'm the real person. I've called people back and they're like, oh my gosh, yeah, hey, it's the guy from YouTube. Yes, it's the guy from YouTube, it's Matt. So anyway, yeah, that's the first don't. The second don't is don't not do some research. So you don't want to go into this blindly. You want to, you know, you might have heard like a friend of yours, or maybe you know somebody that has moved here and they just absolutely loved it. Okay, do your own research though, because maybe it's not right for you. Maybe it's right for that person. Maybe it's been right for dozens of families that I've helped move here, but maybe it's not right for you, okay? So do your research, you know, look at these videos that I have in my channel. I've got, I think, over 100 videos, and they go anywhere from like what the best barbecue is to, you know, the do's and don'ts of moving to New Braunfels, maybe the cost of living, stuff like that. Do your research, okay? So don't not do your research. And I'm gonna say this, and I'm not giving away business, but you know what? Check out other channels too, okay? There's a couple of other channels out there regarding New Braunfels, and they produce some really good content, all right? But check them out, watch those, and then call me, okay? Don't call them, call me. So yeah, do your research, do as much research as you can. I try to provide as much information and as much value as I can to the people that are watching and trying to make that informed decision if they want to move here, okay? Other agents do that too. But yeah, go and watch those other channels. I'm not gonna give you links to them or anything like that. I'm not gonna try to drive away business or anything. That's just, I would be out of business. I wouldn't have a job if I did that. But just do your research though, okay? So yeah, that's the second don't. Don't not do your research. The third don't wait too long. Okay, a couple of years ago, we saw prices just booming. They were just going through the roof. They were skyrocketing, right? And people that waited too long ended up paying more for a house that they wanted than they would have had they made a move when they first contacted me, okay? Or maybe they would have gotten the house that they wanted instead of losing it out to the people that made the decision right then and there, all right? The house that you're thinking about tonight and sleeping on it, somebody else already did that the night before and they're making a decision today. So yeah, don't wait too long. As what happens, like we've had a price correction, which is nice, But what still happens though is prices are still going to increase. Okay, maybe that house that would have been ideal for you is going to be gone. Don't wait too long. There's tons of people moving here. I'm not the only realtor here in New Braunfels that helps people that are relocating. Okay, there are dozens of others. So you don't want to sleep on an opportunity. You know, if you've done your research, you've decided, yes, you know, we've nailed down some neighborhoods, yes, don't wait too long on pulling the trigger on something after you've made that informed decision. Okay. All right. Number four, don't think that it's as inexpensive. I don't want to use the word cheap. Okay. I really don't like the word cheap. It's as inexpensive as it used to be. So when I first started this channel at the beginning of COVID, like right at the beginning of COVID in, I think it was May of 2020 is when I started this channel. And there were tons of people that were just sitting at home. They were in lockdown, sitting at home, consuming content. And I started getting a lot of reach outs of people wanting to move to New Braunfels. And at that time, oh my gosh, the prices were amazing. I had clients who were able to get a house that was over or right around 3,000 square feet for under $300,000. Not gonna find that now, okay? We had price increases that were, you know, like 20%, you know, price increases year over year, which is nuts. I mean, we're used to about a 6.5% appreciation increase, you know, with just natural appreciation of the houses, you know, gaining value. But I mean, during that COVID time when it was just kind of nuts between, you know, 2020, beginning of 2020 to the end of 2022, it's crazy. It's just, I don't know. I'm glad to see the correction where, you know, especially builders and stuff that, you know, they're not just raising their prices. I mean, they're dropping some of these home prices, these new construction builders are going down like almost $100,000. And it was just, there were not as many sellers and there were more buyers because people still wanted to move. So there were bidding wars. I had to get into a bidding war. You know, our house burnt down in March of 2021, and instead of rebuilding, we decided to buy somewhere else. And I found a house, it was perfect in the neighborhood that we wanted. And yeah, I had to get into a bidding war. I had to bid, I think it was over $30,000 above asking price. I won, you know, so hey, I trusted a realtor that I knew, right, to get me in a bidding war. But yeah, I won that bidding war, but we still had to pay above asking price. Luckily, you know, it's valued at more than what we paid for it now, even though we paid above asking price. But yeah, it's not as inexpensive as it used to be. What I paid for my house last year, right? No, in 2021, we're in 2023 now. In 2021, what I paid for it, I'm in the Grove in Vintage Oaks. For what I paid 2 years before, I could have gotten a bigger house in the acreage side on an acre lot for the same amount, which is nuts. So yeah, it's not as inexpensive as it used to be, but it's still cheaper than a lot of places that you might be watching from, which you're gonna let me know. So that couple that got the house that was around 3,000 square feet for under $300,000, they moved here from California because they wanted to be homeowners and they couldn't afford to do it in California, all right? They wanted to be homeowners so bad, they moved away from their families to Texas, to New Braunfels, and bought this house sight unseen. They never stepped foot into it until after they closed on it. They did everything from California. So, but those prices just aren't around anymore. It's still affordable, more affordable than some places. It's more affordable than Austin. You might find cheaper places down in San Antonio in some areas, but you get what you pay for. But yeah, just keep in mind, it's not as cheap as it used to be. So finding a house, like my very first house was a 4-bedroom, 2.5-bath, like over 2,200 square feet, I think like 2,260 or so. And I bought it for 166. My next house was 6.5, 7 years later, whatever it was. And I, 3-bedroom, 2-bath, like 1,940 square feet, nicer house. And I paid 244. The next house had 2.5 years later, paid 340 for it, 2,574 square feet, a Perry home. And yeah, paid 340. The next one, about the same size, and was like $600,000. So, but yeah, keep that in mind. We're not finding those $200,000 homes anymore. If you do find something that's like below 250, it might be a cheap Lennar. and maybe has a garage, probably a two bedroom, one bath, very basic, might not even have a dishwasher, more than likely won't have ceiling fans, stuff like that, bare bones. Anyway, that was number four. Number five, don't expect it to be just like where you moved from, especially if you're moving from California. I've had tons of people that have moved from California, okay? It's not gonna be like California. That's why people move here, okay? California's very liberal, Texas is very conservative. New Braunfels in particular. Now you're gonna have spots, say like in Austin, San Antonio, especially Austin. My least favorite California city is Austin, Texas. That are gonna be moving here that are a lot more liberal than they are conservative. But in New Braunfels, it's more conservative than it is liberal. Keep that in mind. And I'll put, you know, I'll say this too. You're not gonna flip Texas blue. So anyway, the drivers here aren't as friendly all the time. So that's what I hear a lot. You know, like they'll cut you off in traffic, but if you have to merge, they'll be sure to stop to let you in. If you're at a four-way stop, they're gonna make sure that you go first. You know, it's like a Texas traffic jam is a four-way stop. And everybody gets there at the same time. And everybody's like, oh, no, you go. Oh, no, no, you go. No, no, you go. No, it's okay, you go. No, you go, you go. So they're not the best drivers, trust me. Oh, my gosh. What else? Yeah, it gets hot during the summer. We have very mild winters. There's a lot more bugs and creepy crawly things here. Okay? So maybe you didn't have them where you were at. Snakes, tons of snakes, a lot of them that are venomous. I did a video on snakes, so maybe check that out. It shows you some that are venomous and some are not, and how you can tell the difference. But yeah, it's not gonna be like where you move from. Like Texas is a whole other country, all right? Different regions of it are different. Like out in the west, we've got a whole bunch of desert. In the east, there's a bunch of tall trees. And you know, in the south, very, very south, we've got like the valleys, we have the coast, we have the hill country here, where we're at in New Braunfels. So it's just not gonna be like where you move from, okay? So drop that expectation that you think it's gonna be, because it's not. Just embrace it for what it is and be happy that you're here. All right, everybody loves Texas, don't mess with it. All right, we've got the negative out of the way. We've talked about five don'ts. Let's talk about five do's, okay? The number one do, what do you think it is? Call me, shoot me a text, send me an email. All the contact information is down in the description below. All right, give me a call because I can help you out like we've helped dozens of others, okay? Me and my partners were happy to help you. So the first thing to do is call me. I have intimate knowledge. I used to be a police officer here in New Braunfels. I know the city like the back of my hand. Yes, it grows, it's expanding, but you know, being a realtor, driving around all the time, very familiar with it, so it's okay. But yeah, the number one thing, call me, shoot me a text, send me an email. Usually email is one of the easiest things to do. It's mattsalesnb@gmail.com, all right? It's in the description below. That's usually my easiest one because it's right there in front of me. I've got it pulled up all the time. Text messages or phone calls I might miss, email me. So call me, shoot me a text, but yeah, number one, shoot me an email, okay? We'll be able to help you out. Let me know what you're looking for, what your time frame is, all of that. Any questions you may have, yeah, get a hold of me. Number two, come for a visit. Come visit New Braunfels, okay? I've had people that have come out and you know, they're wanting to move here, but they've never been here before. And I've got to vet you. I've got to make sure that you're serious. I'm not a tour guide. I'm not here just to give you a free tour around New Braunfels and go buy you lunch, all right? So we're going to have some assurances of some sort, like a pre-approval letter, something like that, that you want to move here, that you're a qualified buyer, and we're going to be able to move forward. But yes, come for a visit. You know, if it's very early on, like I've had some folks that watch from Wisconsin, and they're at the time they were like 5 years out. I think this was like 2 years ago. We just met for lunch at Cooper's. We went to Cooper's and had lunch. We talked and we didn't even drive around. They did their own exploring. I've got a video where I just drove around New Braunfels for a while. I didn't hit every single street. That would take forever. But yeah, come do your exploring. Come stay for a few days, okay? Get that feel of it, because it might be for you and it might not. You don't know until you get here. So come for a visit if you can, okay? Most everybody that I've been dealing with has been here before. Some people haven't, all right? They just saw it. They're like, yep, I love that place. I'm going to move there. But yeah, come for a visit. That's the second do. Number three is, again, do as much research as possible. Watch as many videos that I have on here as you can. Watch other people's videos on New Braunfels, but call me, okay? Get the information there, but call me, because we might make different content, all right? Like, I might, you know, I make different content than what somebody else might. But, you know, I'm making the content that my viewers like and that, you know, I'm trying to provide that value to them. So yeah, do as much research as you can. Find the pros and cons. I've done pros and cons videos on New Braunfels, but you know what? Watch another agent's like pros and cons. Maybe they have a different perspective of it. Yeah, I've been here for, what did I say, like almost 24 years now in this area. Maybe they just moved here like 3 or 4 years ago. And, you know, they've got a different perspective, a fresher perspective on it. But who knows? Look at it through a different lens, but do your research. Because what I would really hate is if you moved here, I helped you buy a house, and then, you know, 6 months, a year later, you're like, Matt, I freaking hate it here. This isn't for me. I want to move. All right? Because that's just not good. I mean, it's almost like a waste of time for you. So make sure that it's the right place for you, okay? Do your research. All right, another do, explore other areas, all right? I love New Braunfels. That's what I'm here for, okay? I can really help you out in New Braunfels. There's other areas I can help you out too, but explore other areas. Like, there's just south of us is in Seguin, down 46 South. Maybe you'll like Seguin a little bit better. Seguin's got a really good school district just north of it, Navarro ISD, where it's a lot more rural. Maybe you'll like that. Maybe you wanna be up in Canyon Lake for some reason. Maybe you wanna be in San Marcos. I don't know. There's a 55 and up community up in San Marcos. We're gonna get one in New Braunfels, in Viramundi, one of these years, but there's one called Kissing Tree up in San Marcos. So maybe you're 55 and up and you wanna have that active community. Maybe you wanna be in the city. Maybe you just love being in the city. You wanna be in San Antonio. Or maybe you want a small rural area, not quite like Seguin, but maybe like Lavernia, that's gonna be east of San Antonio. Or Fredericksburg. Maybe you want to be in Fredericksburg in the wine country, what we call the wine country of New Braunfels. So Fredericksburg is like our Texas wine capital. There's like 70 different wineries or something like that there. It's insane. They have great wine tours though. And I don't know, my wife and I were looking at buying an Airbnb there a while back before these prices just went nuts, but we shouldn't have waited. We should have bought it. But yeah, explore other areas too. Maybe the areas around here, like Schertz-Cibolo, maybe that's going to be right for you. Yeah, there's a lot around here, and maybe New Braunfels just isn't just what you want, quite what you want. And maybe there's something around here that is though. Okay. So yeah, explore other areas, that may be just right for you. All right. The number one do expect there will be hurdles. Anytime that you're relocating and you're moving even from another city, especially from another state, there's going to be some hurdles, okay? There's going to be some pain. We're here to help ease that pain and make it hurt less, okay? So anybody can help you buy a house, right? But somebody who's been there before, that has bought houses, that has lost houses in a fire, and you know, kind of set their expectations and changes their mindset and their outlook and how they deal with some things. Yeah, just expect there's going to be hurdles. There's going to be some pain points, but we're here to help them hurt less. Okay. Maybe there's going to be a delay in closing on something, but you already had movers lined up. Okay. You had utilities that were ready to get turned on, or something fell through and now you're like, crap. Or maybe you're building and it's taken a lot longer. And now you're like, man, well, I've got to be out of my house over here in the Vegas area, and we've got to move there, but now there's like a 2-month delay on our house. What do we do now? Expect that's going to happen, okay? But use us as a resource. We're here to help. What can we do to overcome this, right? So maybe it's staying at an Airbnb, get a fully furnished, you know, like an executive apartment, something like that, whatever. There's always going to be options for everything, but expect there's going to be hurdles, but also expect that we're going to help you through it. All right. It's not always easy. You know, I've only ever had one house that I bought that it just went smooth. It's like, it's almost too smooth. and like we went and saw it. We put our money down on it. It was a spec home, and put our money down on it that afternoon. And like just over 3 weeks later, we closed. It was great. Like just on time, just like we wanted. Very smooth, no issues. We already had the paperwork and everything ready. Gave it to our lender. It all got done in less than 30 days. So, but that's not always the case. So expect that there's gonna be some hurdles and some pain points. But yeah, so, you know, if you're thinking about moving here, like I said, all the contact information is down below. We'll be able to help you out like we've helped dozens of others. Until next time, y'all take care. We'll see you in the next video.